Let's understand the extent of the oculomotor nucleus from this picture of the lateral aspect of the midbrain. This is the pons. The oculomotor nuclear complex is an elongated group of nuclei situated between the posterior commissure rostrally and the ponto-mesencephalic junction near the trochlear nucleus caudally. If you see from the superior aspect, this would be the dorsal aspect and this would be the ventral aspect. Let's see this orientation from above at the level of the superior colliculus. This is the cerebral aqueduct. As you can see, the main oculomotor nucleus lies ventral to the periaqueductal gray matter. Now, here is a view of the oculomotor nuclear complex from the right lateral aspect, and here is the coronal view from the dorsal aspect. We remember from this the dorsomedial position of the Edinger-Westphal with respect to the main oculomotor nucleus. The inferior rectus motor neurons lie dorsally, primarily in the rostral portion of the ipsilateral nucleus. The superior rectus is the medial most subnucleus. Fibers from this subnucleus cross the midline, pass through the superior rectus subnucleus of the opposite side without synapse, and then turn ventrally to enter the fascicle of the oculomotor nerve. Thus, each superior rectus subnucleus innervates only the contralateral superior rectus. The inferior oblique subnucleus lies in between the medial rectus subnucleus ventrally and the inferior rectus subnucleus dorsally. The central caudate nucleus is a single midline structure located in the caudal end of the oculomotor nucleus complex and supplies both levator palpebrae superioris muscles. To summarize the arrangement of the oculomotor nuclear complex, there are 5 paired subnuclei and 1 unpaired subnucleus. Among the paired are the Edinger-Westphal nuclei that contain bilateral input, the inferior rectus subnucleus dorsally, the inferior oblique in the intermediate column, and the medial rectus ventrally, all of which supply their ipsilateral respective muscles, and the superior rectus subnucleus medially that supplies the contralateral superior rectus muscle. The unpaired single central caudate nucleus supplies both levators. Thus, each oculomotor nerve will have both crossed and uncrossed fibers from this subnucleus. It follows that a complete oculomotor nuclear lesion has the following features. A complete ipsilateral oculomotor palsy that includes internal ophthalmoplegia along with bilateral ptosis and contralateral superior rectus weakness. However, most cases of nuclear oculomotor lesions are partial with the involvement of one or more muscles with or without pupillary involvement. It is to be remembered that in a nuclear oculomotor lesion, ptosis, if present, has to be bilateral or absent. Unilateral ptosis rules out a nuclear lesion. Isolated lesions of the Edinger-Westphal nucleus are rare, as rostral mesencephalic lesions of the periaqueductal gray also result in ophthalmoparesis. However, if they do occur, bilateral dilated pupils with internal ophthalmoplegia result. It thus follows that an isolated unilateral midriasis is almost never related to a nuclear oculomotor palsy. If the central caudate nucleus alone is involved, only bilateral ptosis is seen without any ophthalmoparesis. If it is paired, the other features of a nuclear oculomotor palsy without ptosis of either side will be present. Reiterating the dictum with respect to ptosis, insofar as the nuclear oculomotor lesion goes, either there is bilateral ptosis or no ptosis. When nuclear lesions affect the superior rectus subnucleus, elevation of both eyes is impaired. Since each superior rectus subnucleus also contains axons from the contralateral subnucleus, A unilateral superior rectus subnucleus lesion is effectively a bilateral lesion. Hence, a unilateral superior rectus involvement can never be nuclear in origin. However, this phenomenon can occur if there is involvement of the fascicles after leaving the nucleus. Isolated involvement of the inferior rectus or inferior oblique subnuclei can cause weakness of the respective ipsilateral muscles. However, because of the multiple locations of the medial rectus motor neurons within the subnucleus, isolated unilateral or bilateral medial rectus weakness is almost never of nuclear origin. Now we shall see the modified list of Daroff's rules for identifying nuclear oculomotor lesions. Obligate involvement of the oculomotor nucleus is in the following situations: bilateral oculomotor palsy without ptosis, with or without pupil involvement; unilateral oculomotor palsy with bilateral ptosis; and unilateral oculomotor palsy with contralateral superior rectus paresis. Lesions that may or may not be nuclear in origin include bilateral complete oculomotor palsies, bilateral isolated pupillary involvement, and unilateral involvement of inferior rectus or inferior oblique. Lesions that are extremely unlikely to be nuclear in origin are when there is unilateral oculomotor palsy with or without pupillary involvement with normal contralateral superior rectus function, unilateral ptosis, isolated unilateral or bilateral medial rectus weakness. If you like this video, you may show your appreciation by making a small contribution to help support the channel. Here below the video window, click on Super Thanks. Choose the amount you would like to contribute and then click Buy and Send to complete the transaction. Thank you.